Hi friends, welcome all of you back to my YouTube channel. This is Virtual Teacher. I'm Pons. So today I'm going to publish the Android 9.0 64-bit gltools pre-installed gaming ROM for Vmos Pro application. Here you can see I have already installed that ROM on my device. So you also can install and run this ROM on your device without having and facing any of errors. This ROM is very good ROM for play games, and also it has almost all the Playstore and Google login functions. So here you can see I have already installed Play Store and everything to this ROM. So you also can get these functions to your device after installing it on your device. So let's get start our video and see how we can install and run this ROM. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification and join with me. Before going to install of this ROM, I need to tell you something about this ROM. Because of it was limited to 64-bit devices, we can't install this ROM on 32-bit device. So you need to have at least 64-bit device, and also you need to have at least 4GB RAM on your device. Otherwise you can't be able to run this ROM properly on your device. Okay friends, firstly you need to download and install this Vmos Pro application on your device. If your device is Android 12 one, you need to install this Vmos assistant application also. I have added that guide into the description of this video. Then you will be able to connect this Vmos assistant application and Vmos Pro application together to work with Android 12. If your device isn't Android 12 device, you don't need to install this Vmos assistant. Now you need to open the download folder of your storage, and you need to move that ROM file into the Vmos Pro folder. If your device hasn't that folder called Vmos Pro, you need to create a new folder. Then you need to create a backup folder inside of that folder like this, and you need to move your ROM file into this location. And then you need to start this Vmos Pro application and complete this small startup process. Now click on this plus button to add your virtual machine. Now click here and click on wreck the machine, and you need to restore the ROM file. In the launching process of this ROM, it will ask your password. You need to enter this one as your password, and then you will be able to unlock this ROM. Now our ROM launching process is completed. Then we need to remove the password of this ROM. Now we can try to login with Google to see whether our application is fully compatible with Google or not. Now here you can see we have successfully logged with Google in this Vmos newly installed 9.0 64-bit ROM. You can download your favorite games from here. But there is a small problem of using this Play Store that we installed on this Vmos Pro ROM, because of it's not fully compatible to install our favorite games like Free Fire or PUBG. So you need to use this APK Pure App Store to download any favorite game and application to your device. So let's see whether we can download our Free Fire or PUBG games from using this APK Pure App Store or not. Here you can see you can download and install this Free Fire main application also on your newly installed Android 9.0 ROM from using this APK Pure App Store. Even it doesn't support to install from Play Store. So let's try to setting up this gltools application with this Android 9.0 gaming ROM. Then you need to click on this VM setting. Click on this VM setting option and scroll down. Click on authority management and click on enable this game gyroscope option. Now enable this tick also. It helps you to run this virtual machine freely on background. Then click on allow. Now press back button again. Okay. Now again you need to open this activity launcher application to open your gltools application. Now scroll down and find this gltools application and click on pirate activity. Now click on launch gltools applis option. Now you need to find the application that you want to apply gltools configs. Now I'm going to apply this configs to CPU asset application. Then I can clarify whether we can change our configs of our application using this gltools application or not. If I open this CPU set application, it shows my original device info. Okay, here you can see my original device info. It's a Qualcomm GPU and I have 8 CPU cores on my original device and there is a 4GB RAM. Now I'm going to change this everything using this gltools application. Now close CPU set application and click to open your app list option once again from recent apps. Now click on CPU set and click on this enable custom setting for this app option. When it comes to here, you need to consider about one thing. We don't have much more requirements on our devices, no. So we need to use low game configs on this ROM because this ROM is also taking too much CPU and RAM usage on your original device. So you need to apply low game configs to any game to run that game smoothly on your device. Here you need to select lightweight configs to these applications. If your device has really a 4GB RAM, you need to use 2GB RAM here. Likewise, you need to reduce the RAM requirements for any application using this gltools application. So let's see how we can do that. Click on here and use it master to multiplied option, or you can disable it. Then again you need to change this resolution method to light option. Some game doesn't support to this option, so it's better to leave it as it is. If you can't play any game using this virtual ROM, you need to use this light option. Don't change these settings. If you want to really clarify whether your configs are successfully applied or not to any game, you can use this only screen FPS counter like this, and then you need to use fake GPU and fake RAM info, and also you can use this option if you have much better device but your RAM is limited to 4GB or 2GB or something, you can remove this tick. Now click on this user template option and select Adreno 320 version. And if your device really has 4 CPU cores, you need to select 2 CPU cores. In my case, I have 8 CPU cores, so I can select 4 CPU cores option here. And also, if your device really has 4GB RAM, you can select half of that RAM size. Or if you have 6GB RAM, you can go to 3GB RAM option. Then I'm going to select this 2GB RAM option. It will help me to run any game or application very smoothly on this ROM. Other than that, you need to enable this post app at startup option. And let's see whether our configs are successfully applied to this CPU set application or not. Firstly, you need to close it from recents and launch it once again. When it comes to here, you can see we have successfully changed our GPU vendor and renderer, and also our RAM is reduced to 2GB. And other than this, our CPU cores hasn't changed because of this application is not fully compatible to change CPU cores. Other than this, if you want to change the full GL configs of any ROM using this gltools application, you can press this back button from here and click on this default option. This will help you to change the configs of full ROM. So you can see you can use spec GPU, CPU and other options here. Likewise, you can use this gltools application to change the GL configs of any ROM that comes with Vmos application. So with this, I'm going to wind up this video. Thank you all for watching this tutorial. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification next time, join with me. Thank you.